In the dream, you are falling, lost in the listening distance as dark locks in. Nightfall. Good evening. Tonight, we have something rare, almost miraculous for you. It's the kind of surprising accident that sometimes occurs when two artistic forms meet to the benefit of each. The play by John Douglas has grown out of a song by Stan Rogers. It's called Harris and the Mare.
Harris, my old friend, well met here at day's end. A welcome sight behind yon quiet mare. As hearth is made of stone, by heart a man is known. By heart we've known each other from of old.
Hey, Nielsen. Mark Nielsen, hold on there.
How do, Harris? Out for an evening spin, eh?
Whoa. Yeah, take her out just about every afternoon now. Usually earlier than this, though. I don't often meet up with you on the road. Must be ahead of you most days. Hop in, I'll drive you off home.
Thanks, Harris. I've been walking a lot lately. I think I just maybe will.
Yep. Hup. Come on, old girl. Get those legs moving. Yeah. How are things going at the mill?
Oh, same as always. Had to design a new roller for one of the feeder belts this week. Some smart aleck engineer they brought up from Toronto. He was real surprised a dumb millwright could actually do it. Harris, my old dad and me built half the machinery in that place.
Engineers, what do they know? That was all in them damn automobiles if they had their way.
They mostly have, Harris. Haven't you noticed you're about the last man left around here driving a buggy?
Last man of sense, you mean? Besides, you ain't got a car neither. It isn't as if you couldn't afford it. Millwright's the best paid hand in the mill, so don't say you couldn't.
I like walking. I live in town and no long ways from the mill. Don't need a car. Never did like the way they roar along. Just like they was going their own way, not yours. A mill wheel now, she just does what you build her to do. The car, it's like an angry man. It can go, you know, crazy, smash everything.
So? Yeah. You'll never own one of them stinking noisy things now, will you?
Well, sure I would if I had to. Everybody does what they have to. You know something, Harris?
What?
You're turning into a grouchy old bachelor.
Well, I am a grouchy old bachelor, and I like it. I don't know why you had to marry after so many years, either.
Got run over by a car.
Huh?
Name of Jenny. Best thing ever happened to me.
Well,
you should, too, you know. You're, well, lonely, like I used to be.
Oh, hell, Nielsen. The both of us are outsiders here, and, well, you know it. You, because you wouldn't fight in a war, and me, because...
because you're the town atheist, and you drive around like Grandpa in your one-horse shay.
But I fought in a war. Oh, sorry.
You too?
I didn't mean it that way. Don't know why I said it.
That's okay. Just gets to me sometimes, having to take the wife for a drink in a beverage room called the Vimy Ridge. All the war photos, they keep giving me the eye.
But you'd do it again, wouldn't you?
Sure, of course. Nothing justifies killing a man. Nothing.
Never saw what Kaiser Bill's boys did to the Belgians, did you?
It doesn't change anything. Adding killing to killing.
You know, Nielsen, I guess I just don't understand Christians. I mean, real all-the-way ones like you. I know all about the Bible thumpers and the Jesus howlers. I got their number, all right. But, now tomorrow's Good Friday.
Yeah?
He just let them take him to the killing ground.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got preached about it when I was a kid. Like everybody else, of course. There never was a time I didn't think it was just dumb.
Hey! Hey, Harris! Put a motor on that mare!
Or give her some oats, at least.
Yeah, yeah, she's running out of gas!
Well, go ahead, you damn fools. At least I won't end up in a mess of blood and glass.
Their blood and fire and steel, do they wonder how I feel? That never raised his hand to fellow man. Lust of war and thrill of speed, what life is this to lead? And how they do torment us when they can.
Harris on the road from the mill. Jenny, what is it? What on earth?
That damn Pat Clary's been at it again.
Him. Jenny, I've told you before.
If I had his stupid smirking face here right now,
I've told you before, you can't let him get to you like this. What's he done now?
Oh, same as he always does, coming up to me and Melcher's hardware like I was his, as if we were still going together like we used to.
Jenny, that's dead and gone.
Will you tell him that? Always tried to put a fence around me all the time he knew me.
Maybe he loved you.
Oh, love? Him? He wanted to own me. At least he tried.
Nobody owns you, Jenny.
Not unless I want him to. Oh, that poor dumb lout's got no more idea how to please a woman than fly. Pride's hurt because I married a man near old enough to be my father. You married him because he gets big wages, he says. You married him because he's a conchie and you get to wear the pants, he says.
Jenny, that's enough.
Yeah, I know. And sometimes I almost feel sorry for him, but...
He has every right to be bitter about the war after what happened to him.
Yeah. The woman looks at Clary, first thing she sees is that dead eye.
I guess I just get in the line of fire sometimes.
Oh, if he ever knew what a real man was, Bart, he wouldn't ask why I married you.
Because you're little and fluffy and need a big brute like me to protect you?
Bart Nielsen, I'm just about as fluffy as a she-bear with cubs, and well, you know it. Hey, give me a kiss.
Oh, yeah. Ah, Jenny. I guess it's been one of those days. Mm. Hey, after supper, let's go to the hotel and have a couple of drinks and see who's there, eh?
Oh, sure, Bart. Sure, whatever you like. Well, if we're going to get out, I'd better get supper right away. I'll be closing early because of Good Friday. Oh, but Bart, you got to promise me one thing.
Oh, anything. Anything at all.
You promise me you won't get wild drunk and smash the place up.
The wife and I came out for a quiet glass of stout and a word or two with neighbors in the room. I say neighbors, never friends, it's lest we forget again. But they treat us well enough, and we do them.
A couple of these make you feel better, eh, Jenny?
I guess so.
Aw, oh, come on, Jenny, old girl. Finish that one up and let me get you another.
No, it's okay, Bart. I'm fine for now, thanks.
Ken, could I have another stout, please?
Sure, Nielsen. Just a minute.
How's business, Ken?
You're like the old gray mare, Nielsen. Ain't what she used to be. Hard times and worse coming. Here you are.
Thanks.
You haven't heard any talk about the mill closing down, have you?
Talk's cheap. I don't want to believe everything people say.
Oh, I don't. I don't.
I just thought it'd be a terrible shame for you and the wife. You having such a good job and all.
Yeah, I sure would. Hey, Gord, can I buy you a drink?
I'm fine as I am, Nielsen. Thanks anyway. You I saw in the trap this afternoon with old Harris?
Yeah. Your car sure made us eat dust.
That man's as crazy as a loon.
Oh, Harris is okay.
Why wouldn't he drive with him for nuts? That old Mary his will drop dead in the traces one day, and then where'd you be?
Hi, Nellie. How's things?
Hello, Nielsen.
I say he's crazy.
You know, Bart, I think I'll have that other drink now.
Oh, sure thing, Jenny. Ken, can we have...
But young Clary came in as drunk and wild as sin, and swore the wife would leave the place with him.
Well, well. If it isn't the yellow conscience. And he's with my girl.
Pat, Clary, you're drunk.
This is ladies and escorts only, Pat. You know that. Get across with you to men's beverage room. Now go on.
I have so got a lady. I've got Jenny. She may not have come here with me, but by God, she's mine and she's gonna leave with me.
Clary, let go of her.
Get away from me.
You're going to go with me.
But the wife, as quick as thought, said, no, I'll bloody not. And struck the brute a blow about the head.
Bitch!
He raised his ugly paw, and he lashed her on the jaw, and the wife fell to the floor like she were dead.
Clary, what are you doing?
Stop it, you bloody drunk! Leave her alone!
Gord, make him stop! Stop him! Gord.
Now, Harris, well, you know, I never struck an angry blow. Nor would I keep a friend who raised his hand. I was a conscie in the war, crying, what the hell's this for? But I had to see his blood to be a man.
Oh, never do that again, Clary!
I took him by the coat, spun him round and took his throat, and beat his head upon the parlor door. He dragged out an awful knife, and he roared, I'll have your life. Then he stuck me, and I fell on the floor.
Jenny! Jenny! My God, Jenny!
You thought you'd take her away from me, did you? With your two eyes and your yellow streak down your back!
Blood I was from neck to thigh, bloody murder in his eye, as he shouted out, I'll finish you for sure. But as the knife came down, I lashed out from the ground, and the knife was in his breast.
Killed him. You killed Clary.
Lord, get me away from here. Now.
Please. Help. Help us. Jenny's hurt. She's lying like she's dead. And I'm bleeding. Real bad.
Get out of here, you bloody murderer.
Please. Don't let him escape.
Don't worry. He's not going far like that. Look at that blood.
Oh, please. I beg you.
Get away. Don't you touch me. Get away. Go on now. Get away.
Now with the wife as cold as clay, I carried her away. No hand was raised to help us through the door. And I've brought her half a mile. Now I've had to rest a while. And none of them I'll call a friend no more. For when the knife came down, I was helpless on the ground. No neighbor stayed his hand, I was alone. By God, I was a man, but now I cannot stand. Please, Harris, fetch thy hair and take us home.
Harris, Luke Harris, Harris.
What is it? Is that you, Nielsen? This is a hell of a time of night to be. Oh my God.
Thanks, Harris. I knew you'd answer. If I called, hold up the lantern. That's it. Look.
Oh. What happened? There's blood everywhere. Oh, man, you're in a bad way. And my God, that's Jenny.
Pat Clary went after her at the hotel. He hurt her bad. He cut me up some. And I turned his knife and killed him.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
Harris, get the mayor. Please, get the mayor and take us home.
She's so slow. Better you take...
No one with a car will help us. Oh, Harris. It broke my heart. They were all of them on Clary's side.
Were you surprised?
Yes.
You shouldn't have been. What day is this?
It must be Good Friday by now.
Therefore, when they were gathered together, Pilate said unto them, Whom will ye that I release unto you? Barabbas or Jesus, which is called Christ? And they said, Barabbas. For the other one, his blood be on us and our children.
Very good.
Yeah. Told you they raised me Bible strict. Stay here. I'll get the mare.
Oh, Harris, fetch thy mare and take us out of here. In my 45 years, I'd never known that to call myself a man, for my loved one I must stand. Now, Harris, fetch thy mare and take us home.
You have just heard Harris and the Mare by John Douglas, based on the original song by Stan Rogers. Featured in tonight's cast were Hugh Webster as Harris, and Frank Perry as Nielsen, with Elva Mae Hoover as Jenny, and Richard Donat as Pat Clary. You also heard Marion Waldman and Ken James as Gord and Nellie Mason, and Arch McDonnell as Ken Dockett. The musicians were led by singer-songwriter Stan Rogers and included Bill Garrett, Jim Morrison, Garnet Rogers, Grit Laskin, and David Allen Eady. The recording engineer was John Jessup, with sound effects by Bill Robinson. The production assistant was Peggy Este. Harris and the Mare was produced and directed by the executive producer of Nightfall, Bill Howell. And now, before we hear from your host, here is the complete original version of the song Harris and the Mare.